దేశవ్యాప్తంగా సార్వత్రిక ఎన్నికల ఓట్ల లెక్కింపు కొనసాగుతుంది. హ్యాట్రిక్ విజయం దిశగా ఎన్డీఏ కూటమి కొనసాగుతుంది. ఎన్డీఏ కూటమి ముచ్చటగా మూడోసారి అధికారం చేజిక్కించుకుంది. ఇప్పటికే మెజారిటీ మార్కును దాటింది. అయితే అందరి అంచనాలను తారుమారు చేస్తూ ఇండియా కూటమి ఈసారి భారీగా పుంజుకుంది. కూటమి సైతం దాదాపు 220కు పైగా సీట్లలో ముందంజలో కొనసాగుతుంది. స్టార్ క్యాంపెయినియర్ కాంగ్రెస్ నేత రాహుల్ గాంధీ నేతృత్వంలోని కాంగ్రెస్ 100 మార్కును దాటే దిశగా దూసుకుపోతుంది.
అదే వాళ్ళ సంతోషముంది. എൻ്റെ ഒരു കോളീഗ് ആണ് സുരേഷ് ഗോപി. അദ്ദേഹത്തിന് ഞാൻ കൺഗ്രാജുലേറ്റ് ചെയ്യുന്നു. ഞങ്ങളെല്ലാവരും ഒരു വലിയൊരു സന്തോഷമുള്ള ഒരു മൈൽ സ്റ്റോൺ ആണ് ഇത്. ബി ജെ പിൻ്റെ കേരളയിലൊരു ഗ്രോത്തിന്, എക്സ്പാൻഷന്, സൗത്ത് ഇന്ത്യയിലൊരു എക്സ്പാൻഷന് ഒരു വലിയൊരു ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് മൈൽ സ്റ്റോൺ ആണ് എന്ന് ഞാൻ കരുതുന്നു. ഞാൻ എൻ്റെ ഒരു ഇൻ്റർപ്രിറ്റേഷൻ. സംഭവിച്ചതെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ നമ്മളെ വോട്ട് ഷെയർ ഭയങ്കര നന്നായിട്ട് ഇൻക്രീസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. നമ്മൾ ഇതുവരെ 35.7% വോട്ട് ഷെയർ ഇതുവരെ കിട്ടിയിട്ടില്ല. നമുക്ക് 3.4 lakh വോട്ട് ജനങ്ങൾ ഞങ്ങളെ സപ്പോർട്ട് ചെയ്തു. അതെല്ലാം ഒരു പോസിറ്റീവാണ്. അതെ, ഈ ശരിയാണ്, ഒരു 1.5% ഒരു ഗ്യാപ്പ് ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു ഒരു ഇൻകംബൻറ്റ് സിറ്റിംഗ് എം പിയും ഞങ്ങളുടെ ടാലിയിൽ. അതിൻ്റെ ഒരു അത് നാച്ചുറൽ കോൺസിക്വൻസ് ഓഫ് എൻ ഇലക്ഷൻ. അതിലും അതൊരു പ്രിമച്യൂറാണ്. ഇന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ അതൊന്നും അനലൈസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടില്ല. ഏത് എവിടുന്ന് ബൂത്ത് ഏത് കമ്മിയാണ്, എങ്ങനെ കമ്മിയായി, അതെല്ലാം ഒരു അടുത്ത 2-3 ദിവസത്തിൽ അത് അനലൈസ് ചെയ്തിട്ട് അതെല്ലാം മനസ്സിലാക്കാം. ആ അല്ല, അത് നമുക്ക് നോക്കാം. അത് റിസൾട്ടെല്ലാം വരട്ടെ. ഇത് ശരിയാണ്, നമ്മളുടെ എക്സ്പെക്ടേഷൻ, എക്സിറ്റ് പോളിലെ എക്സ്പെക്ടേഷൻ 350 to 400 ആയിരുന്നു. അത് ഇന്നത്തെ റിസൾട്ട് അത് കുറച്ച് കമ്മിയായിട്ട് കാണുന്നു. അതിൻ്റെ കോൺസിക്വൻസസ് എന്താണ് നമുക്ക് അടുത്ത വരുന്ന ദിവസത്തിലെല്ലാം കാണാം. ശരി. Look, I certainly came here on the 5th of March to win. Me and all my colleagues in the party, my leaders, my karyakartas, the NDA leaders, the NDA karyakartas, we did a very good campaign, a very positive campaign, a campaign about development, prosperity, moving Thiruvananthapuram forward, transforming people's lives. That is the campaign we led. We did not talk about anything negative. Unfortunately, as is the case, maybe in this case, the campaign of the opposing party and the opposing candidates, which was certainly full of lies and certainly full of negativity, prevailed over a few voters. But regardless, we look at this as a record performance for the BJP in Thiruvananthapuram, for the NDA in Thiruvananthapuram. We have polled almost 3.4 lakh votes, unprecedented number of votes. We have polled 35.7%, as I understand today's numbers, which is again a record percentage of votes. And yes, we did come short by about a percentage or percentage and a half of votes. But that is something that we will look into, and we will look to increasing our support.
What do you think that restricted you from getting few more seats in Kerala?
No, it's too early to analyze that and too early to answer that question. But certainly, it was not for want of trying, not want of a vision for Thiruvananthapuram. We campaigned extremely positively. As you know, there are dynamics of certain minority communities and certain narratives that were put out there by the parties, that maybe we were not able to break through and we were not able to expose.
Will you be able to continue here in Thiruvananthapuram?
No, my commitment to Thiruvananthapuram is 100% total. It has nothing to do with me being a successful Lok Sabha MP or not. I have said when I came here on the 5th of March, it is my mission to transform Thiruvananthapuram, and I stand by my mission, and all my colleagues in the BJP and my fellow karyakartas stand by our mission to take Thiruvananthapuram forward.
So BJP open an account in Kerala.
We are very, very happy. We are very excited, and we think it marks a very, very important milestone in the growth and expansion of the BJP in Kerala and in the south of India. Suresh Gopi has worked very, very hard in the Thrissur for the last 10 years. He has contested earlier. This is his third time at electoral politics, and to win by such a huge decisive margin and to put the Congress candidate into third place is certainly a very, very important signal and certainly an important encouragement for the BJP in particular in Thrissur and in Kerala in general. No, it is obviously it is disappointing given the fact that the last 10 years our Prime Minister has worked very hard transformed India significantly. The expectation was that the NDA would be 350 to 400 and we have come short as I see it on TV. We will see the results and we will see what the party and the leadership decides. Thank you.
Thank you.
బీజేపీ కంచుకోట యూపీలో అనూహ్య ఫలితాలు వెలువడుతున్నాయి. 2019 లోక్సభ ఎన్నికలతో పోలిస్తే ఇండియా కూటమి ఇక్కడ మెరుగుపడుతున్న సంకేతాలు కనిపిస్తున్నాయి. ప్రముఖులు బరిలో ఉన్న స్థానాల్లో కౌంటింగ్ ఉత్కంఠ పెంచుతుంది. వారణాసిలో ప్రధాని మోదీ ఆధిక్యంలో కొనసాగుతున్నారు. గుజరాత్లోని గాంధీనగర్లో కేంద్ర హోంమంత్రి అమిత్ షా లీడ్లో ఉన్నారు. కేరళలోని వైనాడు, ఉత్తరప్రదేశ్లోని రాయబరేలీలో రాహుల్ గాంధీ లీడ్లో ఉన్నారు. యూపీలోని కన్నౌజ్లో ఎస్పీ చీఫ్ అఖిలేష్ యాదవ్, మైన్పూర్లో డింపుల్ యాదవ్ ఆధిక్యంలో కొనసాగుతున్నారు. లక్నోలో రక్షణ మంత్రి రాజ్నాథ్ సింగ్ ఆధిక్యంలో ఉన్నారు. ఢిల్లీ, మధ్యప్రదేశ్, బీహార్లో అన్ని స్థానాల్లో బీజేపీ లీడ్లో ఉంది. కర్ణాటక, అస్సాం, మహారాష్ట్ర, ఛత్తీస్గఢ్, ఒడిశాలో మెజార్టీ స్థానాల్లో ఆధిక్యంలో ఉంది. పశ్చిమ బెంగాల్లో టీఎంసీ అధిక స్థానంలో ముందంజలో ఉంది. 25 స్థానాలున్న రాజస్థాన్లో గత ఎన్నికల్లో ఎన్డీఏ కూటమి పూర్తిగా క్లీన్ స్వీప్ చేసింది. ఈసారి మాత్రం ఇరు కూటముల మధ్య హోరాహోరి పోరు కొనసాగుతుంది. ఈశాన్య రాష్ట్రంలోనూ బీజేపీ గ్రాహ పెరిగింది. దీంతో మరోసారి ప్రభుత్వ ఏర్పాటు దిశగా ముందుకు సాగుతుంది. మరోవైపు కొత్తగా ఎన్నిక కానున్న ప్రధాని ప్రమాణ స్వీకారానికి రాష్ట్రపతి భవన్లో ఏర్పాట్లు జరుగుతున్నాయి. జూన్ 9 లేదా 10 కొత్త ప్రధాని బాధ్యతలు చేపట్టనున్నట్లు తెలుస్తుంది. ఈ మేరకు ఢిల్లీ పోలీసులు, భద్రతా సంస్థలు ప్రధాని ప్రమాణ స్వీకార భద్రతా ఏర్పాట్లను ముమ్మరం చేశారు. ఈ కార్యక్రమంలో 12 మంది విదేశీ ప్రముఖులతో సహా దాదాపు 10,000 మంది పాల్గొనే అవకాశం ఉండడంతో ఆ దిశగా ఏర్పాట్లు చేస్తున్నారు.